is that you will have a good time tonight. So please, don't be shy and take as many pictures as possible and post them on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Dengan hashtag, the hope of our fathers. So before we sit back and enjoy, let's put our hands together for the hope of our fathers.
If I pay you, you better fix it.
Good evening, you are tuning live. 8 o'clock news on RTV, and I'm your host tonight, Nicky Randolph. To start off tonight, we've just received news 10 minutes ago that the government has just passed a new law which requires every Malaysian-born male. Yes, you heard it right. Every Malaysian male, upon turning the age of 18, to serve in the government army training program. We have interviewed several people around the country, and this is what they had to say.
我以前是一个护士，安全第一是我的观念。以前我在医院工作的时候，常常看到年轻的阿兵哥，甚至都有断手断脚的。虽然呢，我的孩子才12岁，但他总会18岁嘛。我希望呢，官方能够再三的考虑，因为勉强是没有用的，这样的强制他们会有反效果的耶。如果到最后不能改变，
我会决定把我的孩子带到国外，虽然我很爱这个国家，但我会为着我的孩子的安全为第一，我要一。冇得倾啊，我唔赞成啊，无啦啦做当兵，我打都过。佢老豆我以前啊，大生大死今时今日为咩？有头家啫。以前佢阿爷正我老豆啊，供书教学，希望咩？ 做医生咯，应征咯，老药啊，马路，马路会搞呢？早啲出嚟帮我帮我啦，忙到踢晒脚啊！以后啊，仲要佢哋接手我嘅事业啊，一代传一代啊！哎呀，堕落啊，堕落啊！18岁妹去当兵啊，早啲出嚟帮我啦，系咁啊！
吓，阿妹
Well, stay tuned for the latest updates, and you heard it here first on RTV. This is Ricky Randolph signing off.
Grateful for
for such nice facilities. It's time for him to learn how to be a man. And you, stop spoiling him.
Spoiling him? 我知道我自己做緊啲乜嘢，我想做嘅一切咧都係為個仔好嘅啫。
He is my son too, and I want him to join the army and become a general just like me. Son, there's nothing greater than to serve and protect your country.
No, 我哋嘅family咧有一個 challenge 就夠㗎啦。我個仔仔要出國讀書做 lawyer 啦。Okay, clear?
What lawyer again? One why what? Dance! Become a YouTube sensation!
Recruit! Since when do you decide what you want or don't want to do? Check your attitude. You are going to join the army and become a real soldier.
我不是arguing, and now also very fun already. I'm already in this army camp. I can't go anywhere, not at least in the next 2 years. My life is doomed.
你爹哋都白白白，唔好同佢講，多謝你。嗱，仔仔，你唔使worry，媽咪喺度，聽日咧，媽咪就會同你講，為你handle your meeting，我會竭盡所能將你從呢個鬼地方度救出嚟。
Of course.
Son, if your father was still alive, he'd be so proud of you today. You're following after his footsteps.
He was the bravest man I know. He died and he sacrificed for his country. I want to be like him. Mom, I promise, I'll be the best in this place.
You've always been so quiet. I'm going to miss not having you around. I wanted to buy you a gift, but I've used up all the pension money for groceries.
Mom, it's okay.
But I thought you'd like this.
What is it?
This was the badge that your father wore in his last battle
before he died.
Yes, you can keep it.
Don't disappoint me. 走。
都快。
from you, sir.
Bye, sir. I miss you, bye. Recruits! Maso Mare-san!
Wait, that's right. Hey, what the fuck? Sorry. Breakfast dinner ready. Bagus! Okay. All of you mommy's boys! Sorry. All of you mommy's boys!
Mommy's boys!
You are now in the army.
The army.
Hey, tick, tick, one tick. The goal is right. Tick, tick, tick.
Wait.
Put up, mommy. Put up, hang on. Stand position. Today onwards, no more amal and talk. No more awa makabe.
No.
It's your corporal command.
Jaman.
Mulai hari ini.
Hari ini.
Untuk dua tahun. All of you.
We'll
have to live together.
Sleep together.
Eat together.
Bersama-sama.
Most importantly.
Learn together.
And I will take now in the army, everything you do, you must ask permission. Boy, sir, army.
Who?
Sergeant.
You.
Jalan.
Jalan, huh? Oh, you want my full name, is it? Okay. My name called Jalan. Surname you. Full name you, Jalan. Hey, please, please.
Thank you.
It's the army training, guys. Come on, you think this is what?
Why you show me your cutia? What's the problem?
Sergeant!
A Okay.
Wow, you think I fail, fail you? Okay, okay lah. Okay, okay, okay.
Hey, what's wrong with you?
Nothing, huh?
Oh,
the guys here gets dumped by their girlfriend. Chill, Ben!
Ben, let me tell you this. The government devised this army training program to purposely make us lose our girlfriends.
Yeah, right! So that during the real war, we are able to manage our pain.
Manage our pain.
Control our tears.
And
continue to fight! Continue to fight! What's your problem?
I prefer you, Sergeant.
Okay, guys, let me finish. Amen.
Yeah, remember, when the time comes, you may lose your girlfriend. You never ever lose your country.
Yeah,
exactly.
That's right.
Man, be a man. Just take it that the enemy killed your girlfriend.
Can you say that? You don't understand me.
If your girlfriend down here in this army training program, means she's not worth your time. Just forget about her. Find a new one.
Hey, guys. Maybe all this while,
she's just after your money.
No, she's not like that. You guys don't understand. It's all my fault.
We are meant to be together.
But this army training separated us.
I hate army. I hate this camp. I need to find a way out.
What? Are you crazy? You can't do that. We in army camp.
Wow, you're crazy.
I didn't, man.
We'll be right back.
chain?
Ben? How did you get here?
Doesn't matter how I got here. I've made it. Thank you so much.
Alright.
You know what? I still remember our best team. You give me another chance. What? But I'm already here!
You can't just show up without any warning!
Don't you care about us anymore?
I can't, Ben!
Look, I'm here now!
Ben!
You do this!
Ben, you're hurting
me! You do this now!
Hey, hey, hey! Let them go!
What?
Go to Black Mask Club!
Who do you think you are?
Son, I don't know. live a good and happy life. Have everything you ever dreamed of in this land our forefathers have come to call home. But if one day our nation should call upon us to defend her, my greatest hope is that you will stand up to be counted as a man of honor, willing to lay down your life for our country.
Recruit!
Huh?
What is wrong with you? You've embarrassed me in front of my friends. You know that I used to be an army general. And what do you do? You broke the rules. Not only that, you instigated your friends to leave the army camp. I placed my hope in you. And you slapped my face with your selfishness. Have you ever thought about anyone else other than yourself? You better buck up. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Okay, guys, remember to check tomorrow around. Get ready for tomorrow's test.
Tomorrow's test? Oh, yeah. Let me check. Caps.
Check your cap, right? Yeah.
Jacket.
Make sure the buttons are still there.
Boots.
Check.
Rifle.
Yeah.
Rifle nozzle.
Yeah.
Magazine.
Yep.
Check.
Guys.
William, are you okay? You look like you're looking for something.
Has anyone seen my extra magazine?
But William, I last saw you putting it yesterday.
Yeah, I remember putting it. I gotta check, Father.
Guys. Hey, guys, come. Let's go and help. Come. Quickly. Don't let Chandra know how can he be. The thing isn't even this long. It's right.
If I pay you, better fix it.
Thank you. Kamu semua dihukum dan tidak boleh keluar daripada kamp ini. Faham ke tak? Tapi, boleh pakai handphone.
Hang on, come here.
Thanks, man.
Ben?
Dean?
Ben, if William is still around, he would love to come. Anyway, I can congratulate you, Ben.
Thanks, Auntie. I will miss William so much. Dean, so sorry for what happened.
Oh, don't be sorry. He died a true hero, just like his father.
But how do you know?
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to invite Sergeant Mack to receive the Distinguished Service Medal from General Koo. A round of applause.
A lot of them never acted before. never been on stage except for Sergeant. Hi, how many of you enjoyed Sergeant? Come on, let's give Sergeant. William, Ken, come on, let's give Ken a big hand. Of course, Gabriel acted before. Three of them, right? Three of them. This time, big screen, you know, like, did a good job. And, now I know. Acted before, see one side, never acted before, see another side, enjoy it. So this bunch never acted before. And so, in the beginning, we had to go through a lot. They cannot remember the screen, they cannot act, they cannot bring out emotions, so we had a lot of hard times training, and then, missed rehearsal, forgotten the time. So a lot of fought. I mean, we fought, we quarrel, and like, you know, then they get scolded by pastor. And but in the journey of 2.5 months and working with them from strangers, they've grown to share their pain, share their sad story, how pastor scolded them, and then worked in 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, just for rehearsals. And today, man, they are best of buddies and they work as a team. Aren't you proud of them? I'm proud of them. Come on, let's give them a big hand. So why do I want to talk about this? Because sometimes life is like that. You don't know a lot of people, you're not familiar with them, but then you get to do something. And as a result of doing something, you build that bond, you build that friendship. I just want to share one thought from the scripture. The Bible says this: no love is greater than this, than one who would lay down his life for his friend. You know, it's interesting why Jesus used the word friend. Jesus could have used the word brother. Jesus could have used the word a family, you know, a relative. But Jesus did not. He used the word friend. And here, we see a group of friends come together to serve God, to follow Jesus, and to give their best this Christmas. They could have gone on a holiday, enjoyed themselves, but they stayed back to be involved in this. Why Jesus used friend? Because apart from our family, you grow up in a family, when you grow into your teenage years, your adulthood, probably the single most influential group of people in our lives is our friends. Are you with me? Our friends has a very big role in our lives. Tonight, some of you came because your family came. But probably a lot of us came tonight because our friends brought us to church. And I want to highlight this. If tonight your friend brought you to church, he may not be the coolest guy around, he may not always say the right thing, but if a friend can bring you to church, I want you to know that that is a very good friend. He's not just concerned about your life right now. He's not just concerned about your livelihood. He's concerned for you for all eternity. I want to tell you tonight, we too have a friend, and that friend is called Jesus. If you think about it, He's God. He's our Savior. He's a reason for Christmas. He's a reason for Easter. He could have been just known as the Mighty King, Lord of Lords. But the Bible says that Jesus is also our friend at the same time. When you are a friend, you will know the things of God, the secrets of God. Tonight we do all this. We prepare this entire production and work so hard. They've lost weight, lost their girlfriend, I don't know. Lost their hair, that's for sure. Just so that we can bring you the message that Jesus can be a good friend to all of us. You know, sometimes we think church is kind of like, you know, I don't understand church. I don't know what to expect. I think church are just normal people. And everyone say, how many of you think church are normal people? Christian, yeah. Come on, let's give God a big hand. Hallelujah. We love people love. We enjoy the same thing other people enjoy. We need to eat. We need to eat, Sergeant. We need to sleep. We need to bear up bersama-sama. We need all that thing. But the only difference that singles us out from other people is that we are forgiven by God. Tonight before we go, you know, it's raining and it's going to be traffic out there. But before we go, I want to pray for you. Is it okay? This Christmas season, keep saying, the first Christmas, there was no Christmas tree, no Christmas sale. But I want to pray for you. Because Jesus is the reason for this season. Is it okay? Just close our eyes and bow our heads in prayer. Hallelujah. Tonight in this place, before we go, I'd like to pray for you. I'd like to pray that you will have a friend called Jesus in your life. He's our Lord and our Savior. Maybe it's kind of like a foreign idea to all of us. What does it really mean? Well, the Bible says this: for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. What do you mean by that? All of us has a sinful nature on the inside of us. You know, we don't want to say a lie. Even nobody, when nobody taught us. So God knew that we have a sin problem. And so God sent Jesus Christ to come to our world on that very first Christmas so that He may die on the cross for our sin. And that's what God has done. So what do I do? All I need to do tonight is to open my heart to receive Jesus Christ into my life, to be my Lord and my Savior. And that's the first group of people I want to pray for tonight. You've never invited Jesus Christ into your heart. The second group of people that I want to pray for tonight, I want to pray for those who used to be on fire for God and love Jesus, go to church, but then you got busy. You are having lesser and lesser time to go to church. But tonight, you're here. God is just reminding you of your love. He's not here to judge you. He's not angry. He loves you. Tonight, if you've left God, left the church, maybe you were disappointed. Maybe something happened. Can I just take this opportunity to remind you that He still loves you and God is waiting for you? And so our eyes close and our heads bow. When I count to three, all over this place, tonight, if you want to invite a friend called Jesus Christ into your life to be your Lord and your Savior, when I count to three, you lift up your hands. You say, God, yes, I think I need Jesus Christ. I don't want to celebrate Christmas without Christ. I want God in my life. Or you've been a Christian, you have walked away from God tonight, we can all walk back to God together. And so while all eyes closed and all heads bowed, if you want to make that, say that prayer, make that decision, when I count to three, from the front to the back, my left or my right, lift up your hands as high as you can. 如果今晚你要邀请主耶稣进你们的生命，从你个人的救主，让我数到三，你继续你的手，让我为你祷告，可以吗？ So when I count to three, wherever you are, God is just speaking to your heart right now, touching you right now. When I count to three, are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Lift up your hands. Yes. 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 Hands are going up everywhere. Give it up. Praise Jesus. Amen. Thank you. Lift it up. Yes, sir. Thank you. Yes. 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 Thank you. So many hands being raised tonight. Anyone else here? You say, I need God to come into my life. I need Jesus to be my Lord and my Savior. Anybody else in this place? I want to come to the front one more time before I invite you to come to the front. And I want to pray for you. When I come to the front, if you did not raise your hand earlier, you want to raise it now, I'll wait for you. One more time. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Lift it up. Yes, yes. Praise God. Hands up. everyone. Amen. Without amen. Thank you. I see heads. Interestingly, I see heads right at the back. Can I do one more thing? Can I invite you to stand? Wait. In a while, I invite you to stand. And after that, I'd like you to come to the front. Is that okay? So if you raise your hand, let me pray for you. Let me have the honor to say the first prayer for you. Is that okay? So church, when they come, I want you to give them a super big hand. Is that okay? One, two, three.